Advice. Dear all Buddhist followers, after the ceremony of taking the three refuges and accepting the five precepts, on monthly basis you should come to the monastery to practice the virtues and conducts of a true human in a day. It is the responsibility and obligation of a Buddhist follower taking three refuges and five precepts. Only by learning the laws, principles, virtues and conducts for true humans, can you become people of right virtues and conducts. Without such learning you cannot become virtuous people. People without right virtues could not become Buddhist followers. Is this right? Though you have taken the three refuges and five precepts for 10 or 20 years, if you do not live in accordance with the five precepts of virtues and conducts, you are not a disciple of the Buddha. As Buddhist disciple means a child of the Buddha. A child of the Buddha has to live with virtues and could not be otherwise. Someone who lives like an ordinary worldly person cannot be called Buddhist disciple or one that has already taken ceremony of taking three refuges and five precepts. Is this right? A Buddhist disciple from the start of entering Buddhism has to take the five precepts, that is to accept the five precepts of virtues and conducts. These five precepts of virtues and conducts bring tremendous benefits to the life of all those following the steps of the Buddha. Therefore, you need to learn and practice these five precepts. Without learning and practicing the five precepts of virtues and conducts, you would never deserve being a Buddhist disciple and never become a Buddhist follower. Dear all Buddhist followers, taking the five precepts means you have accepted the five precepts. Accepting the five precepts means accepting the five virtues to be a true human. As such, you should not think little of and overlook these virtues. Overlooking these virtues means to miss priceless things that could not be substituted by anything in this world. Failing to notice these virtues means huge disadvantages in your life, and life after life continuously you will undergo lots of sufferings. Only by holding tightly these five precepts can you escape the animal nature to become true human in Buddhism, to be able to transform your evil karmic debts created from many lives. Thanks to that, you and your family will be in peace and happiness. These five precepts are not many. They are not complicated, difficult, and unattainable for a human being. They are not out of your reach. But why don't you keep them? They are the five standards for one to become a true human being. If any one of the five is not met, the person still has cruel nature of animals. Do you notice this? Take the three refuges and five precepts means to practice to live in goodness. To live in goodness means to be able to transform the suffering karma of self and family. Therefore, when a person take the three refuges and five precepts, both the person and his or her family are in peace and good health. In case of having taken the three refuges and five precepts for a long time but the person and his or her family still get sickness from time to time, having accidents quite often and thus their life is in sadness, restlessness, sufferings etc. This means that the person has only taken the three refuges and five precepts for the sake of the ceremony, for the form, for the name of a Buddhist disciple etc. This means that to take refuge in Buddhism but fail to precisely follow Buddhist teachings. You should do your best to learn, improve yourself and live rightly according to these virtues and conduct so as not to be ungrateful to the Buddha, to my teachings, to bring peace to yourself, to others and to all beings on this planet, to transform this world into a world of heaven. of highest happiness. With full respects, Tam Nhu Monastery.
Determined to practice. Be determined to practice without withdrawal in the lifetime. Keep the body and mind in peace and happiness. Reach to the state of meditation, go beyond the cause and effect. Attain the full enlightenment and lead people to happiness. Tam Nhu. Live alone. He who sits alone, rests alone, walks alone, unindolent, who in solitude controls himself, will find delight in the forest. Dhammapada,